Apple said that over 3 trillion photos were taken on iPhone in 2021. I'm willing to bet that most people don't know all the features that the iPhone camera can do. Here's some of my favorites. Lots of people know that you can use the volume button to take a photo. But did you know that holding the volume button switches from taking a photo to taking a video? You can also hold down the volume up button to take burst photos for something fast moving. These tricks also work when you have headphones attached and you can use it like a remote shutter. Another different way to use the shutter is called Quick Take, which allows you to hold down the shutter button to immediately start recording a video without having to switch to video mode. Sliding to the right locks this in video mode so that way you can lift your finger off the screen, while sliding to the left brings you back into that burst mode we were talking about. Pretty useful way to navigate two of the most popular camera modes. Another popular camera mode is portrait mode. Once you're in portrait mode, you'll see some new options to choose from. On the top right, you'll see what looks like an F, which allows you to adjust the depth of field or how blurry you want the background to be. The lower the number, the blurrier it is. You can change this after the photo is taken, so if you forget, don't worry about it. On the bottom left, you'll see your lens options. Some phones you'll see a 1x, a 3x. Some phones you'll see a 1x and a 2x. You might even see just a 1x. Or on the iPhone 14 Pros, you'll see 1x, 2x, and 3x. Use this to change what lens you're using for the photo. It'll default to a 2x or a 3x because that's most similar to the lens that a photographer would use when taking a portrait of a person on a real camera. The circles in the middle will be used for different lighting effects, like studio lighting, or even blacking out the background entirely. These can also be changed after the photo is taken. Keep in mind though, live photos don't work in portrait mode. I don't know if that changes if you like and subscribe. Feel free to try it, tell me if it works. Speaking of live photos, you can turn those on or off in the top left corner when in regular photo mode. Something that lots of people forget is that you can adjust the live photo effect after you take it, like this. You can change it from a regular live photo, where you hold the screen and play the video, or you can make it into a loop, it'll play automatically, a bounce, which I think is my favorite, it'll go forward and then reverse, or a long exposure, which is great for lights or water maybe. You can also turn off live photo completely here and just have it work as a standard photo. Lastly, one of the coolest modes I think is macro mode. Your wide angle lens or 0.5 lens works as a macro lens as well. And you can either have it automatically switch to that once you get close enough to something, or you can switch it to manual and you're in control when the lens changes. This lens lets you get super close to your subject and capture really incredible detail. As a product photographer, I could say that this feature definitely impressed me. I'll have all the gear that I'm using here listed below. So if you want to support a small channel with some Amazon Associate links, that's where you'll find them. This was a quick one. There's lots of camera modes we did not go into. So let me know if I should do a second one, a part 2, a more advanced maybe, or if you're interested in something else.